Welcome back, Sports Chat
503.
This is Novi Bo with a little NFL recap for ya. What was interesting to you, NFL Week 1, Bo?
Week 1, the Saints-Vikings game to start it off. Kind of surprised. I thought Minnesota would win that one. And I was also a little surprised with the score.
Yeah.
I thought at least one of the teams would have put up a little more points.
Defense seems to do pretty well first couple weeks, though.
Yeah, that's true. The offense is meshing. And
kind of like baseball out of spring training. Pitchers are always going to do well.
Yeah, and then the two games I'm really bummed about are the Niners getting thumped and the
smoked.
Raiders getting thumped.
Yeah, Bay Area was not a good showing.
Yeah, it was rough. Those are my two big teams kind of this year, too. So, yeah. But Skins are doing good right now.
Yeah, and the Skins were your original pick.
Yeah, that's all my way. Super Bowl team, definitely. All the way. But how about you?
I'm a Steeler fan and a Oregon Duck fan. I was glad Dixon got the win today.
Yeah,
really just happy for him on that level. Made some mistakes, but you know he didn't lose in the game. That was the main thing. Yeah. Just don't lose. I was actually really interested in that call that was not the catch for the Lions.
Yeah.
I was really kind of worried. I thought Chicago... I'm kind of a closet Bears fan. I've got the Super Bowl shuffle back there. And I just love Walter Payton. But, man, I've always kind of quasi-rooted for the Bears, you know. And to see them come out and barely beat the Lions. And really, they shouldn't even have won. Lions should have won that game.
Yeah.
Okay, anything else with the NFL? Do you think NFL is dominant? Do you think NFL right now is just... No matter what they do, they could come out and kick field goals all day and people are still going to love it.
Yeah, I think they'll still love it. I guess one thing I like about this year more than the last few years is that there's a lot more parity with the teams. You don't have, like, you're not starting the season saying, all right, Patriots are going to, you know, roll over everybody or, you know, whatnot. Like, even the two teams that got to the Super Bowl last year. They're not even, like, real solid picks for this year.
Is it parity or is it mediocrity?
Are
teams just mediocre? I mean, is it average? Because, I mean, seriously, I think there's only about maybe five elite quarterbacks in the whole league.
Yeah.
I mean, there's guys who I don't even know who these guys are, where they came from.
Yeah, mediocrity would be a good word. Because I also noticed there's a lot of name players, like, named, like, you recognize a name. Who were good a couple years ago?
Yeah.
That are trying to fill out teams, and I don't know.
Well, that was my thought on your whole Washington thing. That's why I really didn't jive with the Washington thing. To me, the last couple years, it seems like the teams that have done huge free agency bids are not really the teams that have been that successful.
Yeah.
So true. I was like, well, I don't know about Washington, man.
Yeah. So it'll be interesting. I can't wait to see. See the Monday night games.
What about Cincinnati? They got kind of worked over by New England early, and then they actually kind of came back and made it a little bit respectful.
Yeah.
Because people are really high on Cincinnati.
Yeah, and you know, actually, I was high on Cincinnati a couple years ago, and I thought they were going to take the next step forward. They took the next step backwards.
Right.
They went out and got T.O. for the season.
Right.
You know, it sounds good on paper. It sounds good to the ear even, but... I don't know. I don't know if they're actually going to be able to get over the hump.
So Carolina is an interesting one to me because we got Jonathan Stewart there, who's a big stud. But they had Colossus in the draft, and I thought that was one of the best picks in the draft. I thought that was a real late pick. They didn't pay much for him.
Yeah.
And he ended up playing. Matt Moore got hurt today. Matt Moore looked really good early on, and then he got hurt, and Colossus came in. If Clausen's the quarterback, I think that they might even have a future in a couple, 3-4 years.
Yeah.
I mean, because truthfully, you know, if you're good, you should be good right away. It shouldn't be like, oh, let's learn the system, and oh, he's just young like this Alex Smith. Like, if you were that good, you should be good.
Yeah.
Like, he's not good.
Yeah.
Straight up. He's just not good. And he's been not good for a long time. So, to me, I mean, I like the idea of starting these guys. Bradford, you know, should be playing. I think Clausen should be playing. And, you know, I know Colt McCoy, I don't think he's in an opportunity to play, but supposedly he's a stud too. Even Tebow. Give these guys some reps, man.
Yeah.
I mean, let these guys get in there and get their thing. I would hate to see Tebow have the biggest selling jersey in the entire league and then not get any reps.
Yeah, not even
play. That's kind of weird. Yeah. Or play on a third down where you got to run the thing and concussionville into the end zone.
Yeah, right. Yeah, no kidding.
That seems weird to me.
Yeah, I don't know. The season will be good this year. I think it'll be, I don't know.
What do you think of the Cowboys? What are your thoughts on them?
Well, I've never personally liked them. No, I think this year, this year they should be good, but like we were saying before, man, they always manage to disappoint.
Oh yeah.
You know, you have all the
nothing better than that field goal that Romo messed up. That was bread and butter.
Yeah, that's a rough way to start. But, you know,
he's heat.
Yeah, but you know, because they've got some good players. They got a new tight end this year.
Yeah.
And, so hopefully they. I don't know. I don't see them going real far, but...
No. I mean, if they're getting beat by Washington, I mean, I thought Dallas would be able to come out and play this game pretty hard. This game is live right now, third quarter, while we're filming this. So they're up 10. Washington's up 10. Not that if Dallas comes back and wins, then obviously what we're saying is bullcrap.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Indy for a second. What about Indy? Indy loses on the first week. I mean, when was the last time that happened?
Yeah, I don't know, man. I guess...
But you know what? Houston has played them tough. Yeah. Every year for the last couple, 3 years.
Yeah.
Indy is one of those teams that's one of the best in the league, but for whatever reason, they couldn't beat the Texans that well.
Yeah.
They would always win kind of at the end, but yeah. Texans always gave them a good run.
Yeah, and like you were saying before, Indy's one of those teams where they come out and sometimes they're a little bit slower to get going at the beginning of the season. Yeah. But like we were talking about also, Houston... is a lot like Indy. Big offense, big passing offense, not much run offense at all, and average defense. And, you know, you get that defense a little bit higher up, a little bit better, and you've got another Indy on your hands.
And if you think about Houston, they've been in the draft every year. They've been great.
Yeah.
I mean, they've had to be stockpiled at this point.
Yeah.
Mature, ready to rumble.
Yep. Yeah, they ended up.
They're a team I'd be waiting. I'm not a betting man, but I would be maybe throwing some money down on their way.
Yeah, and they got Leinart now. I don't think he'll really play much there. But
who's their guy, though? Doesn't they have is they still have the guy Carr? Did they
Carr,
ever?
They
got rid of him. Yeah. Whatever.
Yeah, but yeah.
The Texans.
Yeah.
I've never really paid much attention to them. I've ever seen maybe one or two games of them, like on television, you know?
Yeah.
Like, why would they be broadcast in Portland?
Yeah, I don't know. I think they'll be the team out of Texas this year, though. I think they'll do better than that.
Okay,
Dallas,
so
maybe.
Oh, Dallas just scored. Okay, so who do we think it looked good out of the AFC? Let's do AFC first. I personally think Pittsburgh's defense looked good.
Yeah.
Last year, Atlanta had a great offense, and it was this whole thing of this show and now and then Gonzalez and all this other kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And the defensive that was a hell of a defensive game. I watched that whole game today, and I'm a Pittsburgh fan, and we got Dixon there, so of course I was glued to it. But that was a good game, and that was a good defensive game. That should have been won in regulation, and then you come back and you get Mendenhall run a 50-yarder right down their effing throat. How did that taste? Jeez. After they won the flip or whatever to go to OT.
Yeah.
I think Pittsburgh looks good, and I would have to say... God, I would have to say New England, man. I would have to say New England is ripping right now.
Yeah, and there's not a lot of talk for New England right now. Yeah,
and we haven't seen Baltimore. Baltimore, I think, is right there as well.
Yeah, they picked up Hushmanzada from
Anquan Boldin, dude.
Yeah.
Boldin is going to be the key for them.
Yeah, they've never had much receivers down there.
Flacco's
going to
be awesome.
Yeah, and they usually do pretty good with the tight ends in Baltimore.
Baltimore is the real deal. And I don't buy the Chargers. I don't really buy the Colts, even though the Colts are awesome with Peyton Manning. I don't think there's a lot there. I don't buy the Jets. I think the Jets are gonna lose. I don't think that they're all that awesome. I actually like Miami more than I like the Jets.
Is that right?
Yeah. What about you?
You're
a Dolphin fan.
Yeah, I've always been a Dolphin fan. A little upset they let go of Pat White last week from West Virginia, but
he got crushed though. I saw that last game last year.
Yeah,
he got laid out, dude. He got laid out.
But for the AFC,
you don't have that in baseball.
Yeah, I'm still a Jets guy.
I know.
They got Santonio Holmes, Sanchez. They picked up. LT in the offseason.
Yeah, I just don't see it. I see them falling back to. I see sophomore slump.
Yeah.
I mean, I just don't see them long term.
Yeah, it'll be a great test against the Ravens to see where they're at.
Yeah, I like Pitt. I think, I mean, I think if we can get Roethlisberger back, I think we're good to go. I think Pitt is better off than the Bengals, and I think people were higher on the Bengals than Pittsburgh. I think Pittsburgh going into the season is a better team than Cincinnati.
Yeah,
and if people are high on the Cincinnati, then they should be high on Pittsburgh. I think Pittsburgh's better.
Yeah.
They got a better running game. Yeah. They got a more solid defense, and that's the key. You know, all this stuff about who's ever got a better quarterback. Quarterback doesn't win every single game.
Yeah.
If it's a 9-9 ball game, that quarterback hasn't done crap.
Yeah.
It's the kicker. Okay?
Yeah.
So, I mean, to be honest, you know, like Matt Ryan today or Dennis Dixon, who did better? Well, Dennis Dixon because his team won. But Matt Ryan's twice the quarterback Dennis Dixon is.
Yeah.
10 times the quarterback Dennis Dixon is at the moment. Oh, yeah. Dixon looked pretty good, though. I'm going to talk about Dixon for a second. Dixon looked good. For Pittsburgh fans or Oregon fans out there, I really liked what they did with Dixon. They got him out of the pocket.
Yeah.
The most important thing about Big Ben is that Big Ben is his same size almost as those freaking linemen.
Yeah.
So when those linemen go hang their big meat hooks on him, he doesn't get phased. Yeah. He can still throw a freaking rocket shot 15, 20 yards on a laser across the middle through linemen because he's just as big. Dixon, he could get freaking breathed on the wrong way and he's down.
Yeah, that's why mobility.
So get him out of the pocket, let him see the field, and let him throw on the run. He's more comfortable on the run probably anyway.
Yeah.
And if the thing's not there, he's already moving. It's like that delayed steal. You're already kind of running in baseball. Yeah, Why not go? Go! You're already kind of running.
Yeah.
So Dixon, by rolling out, by getting his feet moving underneath him, instead of him standing in the pocket like a statue, get him moving and get him to throw that ball. He threw a nice couple screen passes and he had a couple good looks. The key with Dixon is hand the effing ball off.
Yeah.
Punch those people in the face. Get the ball moving. It doesn't matter. You can grind all game. This is exactly what Pittsburgh did today. They grinded all game and they broke one. And the one they broke was in freaking overtime and it was right down their effing throat. Okay, who do you like in the NFC?
NFC, still Redskins guy. I also, like I was talking about, I like the Niners. Niners
Giants,
went down big today.
I think Giants look good.
Yeah.
Niners are pathetic. I'm sorry.
Oh, come on, man.
Good D. They got smoked by the Seahawks? The Seahawks are not good.
I agree. Dude, the Seahawks are not good.
Even if it's the 12th man. Bullshit.
I agree.
Guys in the stands who are drunk don't matter. But, dude, I was pissed. Because I'm a Niner fan, too. I love the Niners, dude. And I was pissed. Because I hate the Seahawks, to be brutally honest. And now they got Pete Carroll, I kind of hate him even more.
Yeah.
So, dude, to me, the Niners went out and did nothing. I mean, nothing today. And I watched it. Yeah. They got good solid line linebackers, and they have some solidness on the O line. It's young, but it's solid. But I was so upset with them.
Yeah.
I think that I've always been a fan of the Eagles. I think Andy Reid does a great job. His teams are always there, but I don't believe in the young quarterback with them. I was a McNabb guy. I still am. I think that McNabb with that team, you're still in the playoffs. You're still right there at the NFC Championship, or we're close to it.
Yeah.
I think Green Bay has a really good shot this year.
Yeah, Rodgers had a good game today.
If they can do things, I mean, if they can get out of somebody's way a little bit, they already beat Philadelphia early. If they can just start kind of getting out of people's way and just have they could be 13 wins, 14 wins real easy.
Yeah.
Real easy.
Yeah, that division with Minnesota and the Packers and...
The Saints, Minnesota, they have a chance to go back to the NFC Championship, you think? Either of those teams?
I know the Saints won't.
I don't see either team. I'm just going to say, I don't see either team going unless crazy Brett Favre magic dust from the sands of time come down.
Yeah, you know, if I have to answer, I'd say no. You know, I like to see Minnesota go back.
I would too. I would too.
Minnesota connections, but you know,
Favre alone. I mean, there's nobody who I'd rather watch than Favre.
Yeah, yeah.
I think it could be the Giants, and I think the Giants coming down, and the Giants and the Pack Attack.
Yeah.
Okay, YouTube, thanks a lot for the extra long video. Our ramblings are brought to you by today. The dude who goes in full face paint to the game just to watch his team lose and then to think about real quick, do I go to the bathroom and wash this off or do I walk around the rest of the time looking like a jackass because my team lost and I painted my fucking face. All right, YouTube. Peace. I hope all is well. Go check the duck videos if you're interested in that.
Be good.
All right, adios.